Hi, I'm Todd Clippinger, and welcome to the American Craftsman Workshop. I always love talking with other woodworkers, hearing stories from the shop and how they got interested in woodworking. And recently I was talking to one of the local woodworkers, and I really loved his story and found it interesting how he got into woodworking. And I had to ask him if I could do an interview with him and share his story with you guys. And so he agreed. So I'd like to introduce you to Madison Swords. He's a 17-year-old woodworker from Billings, Montana. He's a self-taught woodworker, learned everything from YouTube videos, learned how to make hand tools, learned how to sharpen hand tools properly to razor sharpness, learned joinery, all from YouTube videos. And what was really impressive was his first project they decided to tackle was a green side table. So rather than tell you any more about Madison, and his story of how he got into woodworking, I will leave that up to him in his own words.
Well, I've been building things with my hands for quite a long time. I built these benches when I was 9, but really got into more of the fine woodworking about a year ago. And it all started just seeing some videos of people working on YouTube, and I thought that looked like a lot of fun. So I went out and cut a little dovetail joint, and it just kind of exploded from there. Well, when I first started actual woodworking as opposed to making, it was for the purpose of modifying folding knives and then selling them on the internet. And from there, I kind of got into joinery more than woodworking. So I would just make, you know, little mortise and tenon models or dovetail models or, you know, half lap joints. And then from there, I was like, just kind of needed to apply those skills, and so I started building, you know, small boxes, and I'm currently working on a green end table, and I really don't know where I'm going to go from there, but hopefully it's somewhere positive. I really enjoy the way that woodworking combines both technical skill as well as there's a lot of subjective components to it. I mean, you can make a beautifully joined table, but if you don't match the grain correctly, it's going to look horrible. So it's just kind of that left brain, right brain mixture that I really enjoy, and just being able to think physically, I suppose, I find really enjoyable and relaxing. Well, my process is kind of backwards from most people, where I tend to purchase material first and then find things to do with it. That's how this green table started, is I purchased some mahogany and needed to use it. And so I made that, and I still have quite a bit of leftovers, and that might end up as a guitar or possibly another table, something to match this other one. And I don't know, I just like having the material around. That way there's really no obstruction to the idea. Well, a lot of the tools that I use primarily actually came from my great-grandfather and my great-great-grandfather, and they've just kind of been handed down, and they still work excellently. But there is a need for new tools. Got the table saw from my father, and I probably have no more than $150 invested in all of my tools. The only things that I buy new are edge tools, such as chisels, and then I have purchased one hand plane, but really I started as a very simple shop with just 2 saws and 1 chisel. Well, I primarily use hand tools for a variety of reasons. Number one is working in a small shop. I really don't have the room for all the necessary power tools that I would need, but also I just find it a lot more relaxing working with hand tools than with power tools. And for having woodworking as a hobby as opposed to a job, I really don't care how quickly something gets done. It's more about the process for me. So being able to just sit down and plane on something for an hour, I find much more enjoyable than passing it through a planer. I do, of course, use a table saw is really the only power tool that I use frequently. And that's just because, you know, ripping down 8-quarter stock with a handsaw gets really boring after a while, and you kind of just want to get things done. But I'm primarily a hand tool woodworker. So with my limited tool selection and also my limited budget, I sometimes make my own tools. And I find that making your own tools, in addition to actually having the tool to do the work that you need, it also gives you a much better understanding of that tool and how to use it and what makes it good or bad. And also you just get a lot more connection with that tool when it's something you made and that you use every day. When I was growing up, we had a 3-car garage with benches on all walls and, you know, just an absolutely massive shop because no one ever parked in there. But when we moved to this house, I was pretty sure to claim half of it as soon as we moved in because I knew that I was going to be doing something, not necessarily woodworking, but I knew I would need some space to work in here, and they've always just kind of been very accommodating of that, and parking out in the driveway. But yeah, it can be a little tough just having so much stuff and especially noise because my shop is right below their bedroom, so nothing after 8 o'clock really. Well, in the future, I really would like to move into a larger shop. As cozy as mine is, I would like to have some more space to work in and also to house more tools. Because there are certain things that you really just can't do with hand tools that I would really like to work with. And I think having both the space and the tools would allow me to explore more as a woodworker. Looking into the future, I'll probably keep woodworking mostly as a hobby because it gives me a chance to relax and take my time with the work and do it the way that I would want to do it. I would like to obviously expand and learn as much as I can just to kind of develop that hobby and become more and more proficient with it.
Well, guys, I hope that you enjoyed that interview with Madison Swords. I really had a great time talking to him. You know what? He's grabbing information off the internet and taking it out and putting it to practical use in the shop right away. He's grown so much in a very short time, and he's all self-taught. There's some great lessons there in what he shares. So I hope you found it inspirational and encouraging, and will drive you to get out in the shop and build more too. Well, that's all I have for you this time, guys. And until next time, be safe in your own shop.
Testing, check. Testing, 1, 2, check.
So tell me, do you have any pets?
I do. I have one cat and one dog.
What do they think of your woodworking?
They're pretty indifferent to it.
Okay.